will start a new problem on differential band break. The question is like this. A differential band break shown in figure operates on a drum diameter of 600 mm. The band is 3.2 mm into 100 mm and coefficient of friction is 0.22. Determine first one, least force required at the end of operating lever when the band is subjected to a stress of 55 Nm², torque applied to the brake drum shaft. Third one, is this brake is self-locking? Prove your answer. And the sketch he has given that we need to consider. We have to list out the given data for this given problem. A differential band brake shown in figure operates a drum diameter of 600 mm. So here diameter D he has given 600 mm, that we need to convert into radius. Radius R is equal to 300 mm. The band is 3.2 mm into 100 mm. So here size of the belt he has given H into B, thickness into breadth. That value has given 3.2 mm into 100 mm. So this is a flat belt, or say it is a band. Band with the dimension, say rectangle, 3.2 mm thickness and breadth is equal to 100 mm. And coefficient of friction is 0.22, that is mu is equal to 0.22. Determine first one, least force required at the end of operating lever when the band is subjected to a stress of 55 Nm². Here he asked to find force F, but here we supposed to consider one of the entity, that is we must evaluate effort, that is for both clockwise and counterclockwise rotation, because here he asked to find least force, means we supposed to compare both. And stress he has given, stress is equal to 55 Nm², that is sigma D. Then torque applied to the brake drum shaft, so T is equal to question mark. Next, is this brake is self-locking? Final question is, brake is self-locking, and prove your answer. We have to give the justification. This is all about the given problem. Now we have to list out the various equations are required to solve this particular problem. So now I have sent a pic in page number 270. We must consider condition for differential band break. So here, since he asked to find least force required F, so we must use both the equation for clockwise as well as counterclockwise direction. For clockwise direction, in equation number, in the above pic it has shown, it is clear. Force F is equal to B2 F1 minus B1 F2 divided by A. We must call that as equation number 1. And ratio F1 by F2 is equal to E raised to mu theta. And width of the band B is equal to F1 divided by H into sigma D. This we need to consider. In page number 269 and 270, these are the equations are there. Least force required F as well as width of the band B is equal to F1 divided by H into sigma D. Please refer that pick you are getting that particular equation. Next one is the torque applied to the band T. Here we know the relation. To find the torque, we know the relation T is equal to FT into R. That FT is nothing but F1 minus F2 into radius. So F1 and F2 we are getting in previous case itself while evaluating least force required F. And to check the self-locking, we supposed to prove if it is a self-locking, means the value of force either clockwise or counterclockwise supposed to be equal to 0 or less than 0. Then only it is self-locking, else it is not self-locking. That condition we supposed to prove. Now we must find the first unknown, that is least force required either in case of clockwise or counterclockwise direction. So now here, for clockwise direction, just use the relation F is equal to B2 F1 minus B1 F2 by A, and by referring the data handbook, hope you already listed the value of A, B1 and B2. Value of A is equal to distance from fulcrum to the point of application of the load. That distance is 225 mm.
and b1 is equal to 38 and b2 is equal to 127 mm. That you need to consider. And the first unknown to evaluate, find out the use that equation and then go for the equation. Call that as equation number 1 and use the equation width b is equal to f1 divided by h into sigma d, that is to find the value f, f1. After finding the value of f1, hope you got the f1 value is equal to 17.6 into 10 to 3 newton. Then use the equation ratio of tensions, that is f1 divided by f2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. And theta value has given in this sketch, that is 300 degree. Convert that into radians. So you are getting 5.236 radians. And F1 value, you know, that is 17.6 into 10 to 3 newton. And substitute in equation number 2. You are getting the value F2 is equal to 5562.11 newton. And substitute these two values, F1 and F2, in equation number 1, what you are called. You are getting the value force. For a clockwise rotation, that is 8994.8 newton. Evaluate this. In the same fashion, we must evaluate the force for counterclockwise rotation. In that F2 and F1 value has interchanged, that's it. So from that we are getting the value force F is equal to 167.05 newton, and compare both, the least force is 167.05. That is all about the first unknown. Next, find out the second unknown, that is torque required to apply the brake. T is equal to F1 minus F2 into R. We know the value both F1 and F2. Substitute, as well as R, substitute. We are getting the torque 3.61113 into 10 to 6 Newton millimeter. Do this. And the third unknown he has, that is brake is the brake is self-locking, by referring the effort required the both direction, that is clockwise and counterclockwise, is positive and is not equal to zero. Hence the brake is not a self-locking. This is the final conclusion of this particular problem. Do this.